to the vantage point again that, you know, at time when Thomas wasn't there, what was that struggle for him that whole week when the disciples, his apostles, his friends said, hey, we've seen Jesus? And what was going through his mind, what was going through his heart that he couldn't believe them? But we, you know, the resurrection is something that is just beyond comprehension. So I can understand his difficulty, but he must have known his friends well enough to know that they weren't joking. But yet, whatever their transformation he had to have in his heart, had to take place. And so that week, we don't know the angst, the fear, or the confusion, but those normal emotions that he had, we can't discount, because sometimes we just idolize saints and we don't realize their humanity. So there is a week of him in this time of uncertainty. And then when Jesus is standing before him, I can see this as, even though there's all these people around, it's as if nobody else was in the room except for Thomas and Jesus. In this very intimate, personal moment, where it's interesting that he says, unless I see the mark, he wanted to see before he could touch. And then after the touch, I'm sure that it was Jesus that took Thomas' hand to actually put it into his wounded hand, that glorified hand, that glorified side. And you can just imagine this deep intimacy. And, you know, when Thomas then just falls and says, my Lord and my God, there must have been great tears there of embarrassment. Maybe he felt a little shame. Maybe he was just so overjoyed. We don't know what those emotions were because it's not in here. It would be great to hear what they were. But what's important is that wherever we are in our lives and are pondering and doubting and questioning, Jesus will come to us. He does come to us. And it's a very personal, intimate moment for us. And in most profoundly, it happens when we come up for the Eucharist. And that's why it's important for us to, we're going to receive him, to really try our best to have that with God when we kneel down before we come up to him. To really think about that intimacy of him coming to us in this Eucharist and receiving him. And, you know, and trusting on the deepest level of our being that Jesus is transforming us. He's helping us through this difficult time in our country and in our world. He's helping us in our own personal relationships, and even in our own spiritual journey, that he is ever so intimate with us. And I can just imagine the grin on Jesus' face. Thomas was just in unbelief, but yet believed. And that same beautiful smile, however he embraced Thomas, is the same grace, the same gift that he gives to each of us. So let us just ask.